Your Excellency, Mohammed Al-Jadaan, Saudi Arabia's Finance Minister, thank you for joining us on Bloomberg TV. You're just announcing the budget now for 2022. We've seen throughout the course of the pandemic, we've had something of a revenue crisis throughout that period of time. Now we're having revenue bouncing back again, but you're sticking with spending plans. Is this the end of this oil curse boom-bust cycle for Saudi Arabia?
Thank you very much for having me, and indeed it is. I mean, it is a very important day, but it is actually a very important era for Saudi Arabia. We have been working on this for an extended period of time under Vision 2030, where we wanted to diversify our economy, but also diversify our revenues, and we wanted to make sure that we have a stability so that our budget does not fluctuate based on revenues, but actually provide a sustainable fiscal framework that will enable us to plan better as government, but also enable the economy and the private sector to plan better. So regardless of the revenues, you know, the budget ceilings are set based on a formula that will not fluctuate in the future.
Yeah. And for 2022, you're forecasting a budget surplus now, for the first budget surplus in 8 years, I think. How much of that is due to higher oil prices? And also, how are you going to allocate that money now, that additional cash that you have in the Treasury?
I mean, the budget will likely show a surplus of about 90 billion Saudi riyals. That is a result of three factors. One is more efficiency in the government. So you could see that actually the spending is less than last year and even some of the years before. But also part of it comes from additional oil revenues and non-oil revenues that we have increased over the last several years. I mean, we quadruple non-oil revenues over the last 5 years. So it's three factors, really. Less spending, more oil revenue, and more non-oil revenue.
And so what does this surplus mean for the kingdom's borrowing plans? You've been a frequent issuer over the past few years. As you go now into a surplus, will you still be looking at tapping markets?
We will obviously tap the market. I mean, we need to maintain our relationship with investors. We will use debt market to refinance some of the maturities that are going to happen in the future. And we will also be looking to issue a green bond to finance some of our green initiatives that have been announced under the Saudi Green Initiative. We will also tap the market if there are good opportunities to even increase our reserves. So there are opportunities, but we will be very careful, and we want to make sure that we borrow at the right price and the right circumstances.
There's a huge interest at the moment from investors in this ESG space and in green bonds. What more can you tell us about your plans? When will we see Saudi Arabia come out with a green bond? And is this also going to be in conjunction with the PIF? I mean, they also have their green bond plans as well. So this is going to be two separate things coming?
We are separate from PIF. PIF have their own governance and separate legal entity, so they will borrow based on their board's instructions and their strategy. As sovereign, we will issue. Other companies in Saudi Arabia have already issued green bonds. We have, as we have announced under the Saudi Green Initiative, we are taking climate change very seriously. We are investing heavily on our energy mix. We are investing heavily on renewables. And these all qualify for green funding and financing. So we will issue next year, most likely. Again, it depends on the market conditions. We are taking ESG very seriously. We have a very strong now task force that ensures that the government at large coordinates to bring about a more disclosure when it comes to ESG and green bonds.
So when will we next see the sovereign back out in the debt markets?
As we have always said, you cannot pinpoint a date when it comes to the market, because you know you need to tap the market at the right time, but most likely in the first quarter.
And you mentioned there the energy transition as well. And this is obviously a very crucial time in the energy industry. How does your investments that are going into the Saudi Green Initiative also, you know, reconcile with you're also as a country investing in expanding oil and gas production quite dramatically? How do you balance those two aspect?
We don't see any contradiction in the two. I think the main message that I've been telling people is transition does not happen over a day. You need to transition over time, and you need to have a proper plan for transition. If you de-invest on current energy, like fossil fuel, then you need to be sure that you have the alternative, and the alternative is not available in the scale that the fossil fuel currently fuels the world. So you need to continue investing in fossil fuel, but also in a responsible and sensible way, less emission, and invest in technologies that reduces, recaptures, reuses, recycles the emissions from fossil fuel. At the same time, as we have announced under the Saudi Green Initiative, we are investing heavily in our energy mix, where 50% will be renewable. So there is no contradiction. We wanted to make sure that we and the world, actually, we are also looking at the world economy and making sure that there will be enough supply of energy to the world until the transition happens.
Yeah. Markets took a dive on the news of Omicron when this variant started spreading a few weeks ago. I mean, there has been some recovery since then, but we've also got, you know, inflation and supply chain problems. Looking at your forecast into 2022, how much of a downside risk do you see to those?
I mean, we looked at all these risks, obviously, when we designed the framework and calculated the budget numbers, including revenues and the growth potential. We are likely to see actually very healthy growth, possibly the highest for a long time, 7.4%. We are expecting the GDP, real GDP growth next year, taking in consideration the downside risk that you mentioned. We are also investing heavily in our health system to make sure that we don't have to take extra measures to that may impact the economy. So we want to make sure that our health system is resilient and able to sustain any increase in cases, God forbid.
So no more lockdowns in Saudi Arabia?
I am very optimistic, no more lockdowns.